It wouldn't be Eurovision if it wasn't this year going to be surrounded in controversy. Truly, I've never come into a Eurovision where so many countries have their own issues with certain songs. For example, I played Joanne, which I felt ought to have won for Norway. And in my viewpoint and in my reaction, you can see that on my channel. Please like, subscribe for that to watch more Eurovision reactions. I felt this particular artist was pushed aside for them to choose a safe option. The same was said in Poland, but what they had done was there was connections between the judges and the artists that the judges selected to win and represent Poland this year in the Eurovision. So there was a whole euphoria in Poland about how dare you, we're the public, we voted for the second person who was the runner-up called Jan. And Jan has got protests all over the social media still at the moment in regards to they want him to represent Poland, not, I can't for legal reasons mention the artist that's gone forth. So that's a controversy in itself. And I question Norway's. I'm not saying there's a controversy, but I did feel their representative gone forth is extremely weak. And for a Nordic country that is so full of exciting and beautiful music and artists, I wondered what happened here. So I questioned that. But with Vesna from the Czech Republic, I have two sides of the argument here that we are going to have to discuss after we listened, and then it'll make sense. Because before I get to the lyrics, there's people asking, I find this too political. Like, I think it was the country Belarus a couple of years ago. They were just not disqualified. They were allowed to go forth, but they didn't get through to the final because their song was too political. People are saying Vesna's is as well, my sister's crown. What does it really mean to represent? Well, that is why I'm here, to shed a little bit of light and to give you my interpretation of the lyrics as I see the lyrics in front of me. They are saying one thing, the band, but people are saying it's leaning towards the Ukraine war, their support, and it's too political. I feel it's not. And for that reason, I think we need to just have a little bit of bio about the group that's causing the controversy. They are an all-female band called Vesna, led by acclaimed singer and songwriter Patricie Kaňok. They launched their debut album, Paterboyn, the Fifth Goddess, during a fairy tale-inspired concert with the Prague Symphony Orchestra, one of the most esteemed in the world, by the way. It was quickly nominated for the Andel Award for Discovery of the Year. At the height of the COVID-19 pandemic, Vesna used the lockdown to record a new album called Anima, which solidified their position on the pop scene at number one, while at the same time allowing them to retain their distinctive folk and dreaminess. The band scored a radio hit with the song Naktriek Petruk, On the Wings of a Dragon, and in February 2022, Vesna joined the Chechenian artists at a charity concert in Wesela Square to show their support for Ukraine, you see. So that started the memento of people like rather than, getting the facts. Now, the facts from this particular female group is this, and this is what they say. They say the background in an interview with the Eurovision fansite ESC Bubble. Two members of the band reported that the band frontman and songwriter Patricie Kaňok wanted to share about a story of sisterhood and as a protest against gender inequality. No mention of Ukraine war here, saying that you can have support from other people on the subject of equality. It's not just between women, but for everyone. And so this is the song that people say, but they've got now hidden lyrics. What's hidden about it? The band have said it's about gender inequality. And I think if people in the Czech Republic, 70% worldwide voted for them, 30% in their own country, because the Czech Republic is a very conservative country, like many European countries, when it comes to gender inequality or promoting, let's say, issues that they would prefer to not speak about. But this band's song is about that. It's about bringing forth, in the lyrics, in the video, gender inequality, and protesting against that. But then we have other reports that say Czech Republic around the world crowned Vesna as the winner of the show. And the results were given. And what they said in other websites, not the band, everybody themselves, was that the song sent a strong message of solidarity and support to Ukraine and goes against Putin's propaganda regarding non-existence of the Ukraine nation. Well, I'm sorry, everybody, that's not what the band's frontman, who wrote the song, said. It's about gender inequality. I'm going to let you listen, watch the video, study it. I'm going to see if there's any hidden messages. I don't think there is. But for controversy, that always showcases, I think, a lot, doesn't it? It makes a band stand out. But to stand out for the wrong reasons, and other social media outlets put them into a box and say, their song represents this, when the person who wrote the song said, excuse me, this is about gender inequality, it's not about the Ukraine war. Just because we're five female members of a band, yes, they might support the sisterhood of the Ukraine women and what they're going through. Who doesn't? I'm a man and I support it. But is it about that? Let's listen to the video, let's study it, and then I'll give you the lyrics straight after. Take it away, Vesna, my fourth, number four in my top five for to appear in the top five in Eurovision 2022 in Liverpool with my sister's crown. And I'll talk about the lyrics straight after.
Moje sestra do kouta nepůjde, ani tebe poslouchat nebude. Moje sestra v srdci je divoká, co by zaplést nikdy si nenechá. Moje sestra do kouta nepůjde, ani tebe poslouchat nebude. Dolls, we are not your dolls. Life's not a money bag, a
Wow, Vesna, that's the first time I've seen it in my how can I say, it's the first time in its entirety I've seen the video. Good grief, everybody, stop making it so political. It's so about gender inequality. I'm a gay man and I'm going to speak from the heart here as a musical reactor. The music was phenomenal. That is a first-class video. Sisters of the world, brothers of the world as well. And those with the feminine side, hey, we're all sisters. But listen, Vesna, my sister's crown. Wow. Good instinct on the images and the lyrics told me. And because of the controversy, that you deserved a place in my top five. And I'm so glad I put you as even as number four. There's no really number one, number two, number three, number to five. I still think if there was justice, France would win it. Just my saying as a musical reactor, there's reasons I've mentioned in that reaction, go and check it out. But I have to talk about this. I have to get straight into the lyrics because I am beginning to get quite angry and wonder why. I wonder if there's a propaganda going on at this year's Eurovision with certain acts being pushed aside, like Joanne, like Jan, because Vesna is singing about that. Joanne and Jan got pushed aside because of, well, Jan got called by one of the judges, by the way, in Poland as demonic. Imagine labeling an artist that wanted to represent your country that and justified, and it was a female that said that. Disgusting. Disgusting, really, to label an artist as demonic. That's why she didn't vote for them. Vote for Jan to go forth. Absolutely horrendous, Poland. And all you judges should be sacked. Sacked for saying that. That's defamation. But Vesna is not singing. I'm not seeing what other people are saying. And I'm trying at the moment to quickly bring up the lyrics as well because I just don't see it, everybody. I don't see what yous are seeing. It says, "My sister's crown, take it down, don't take it down. Nobody has the right to do it. She's beautiful and capable. She's her own queen and she will prove it." Now, when you say she is her own queen, that is a gender-associated gay phrase that's used a lot amongst the community at large. And I will say community because we are, no matter what genre you put yourself in sexually, we are of the same community at the end of the day. Because we are representing ourselves under one umbrella. And the song is about love and peace and unity. Where does it say it's about Putin and Ukraine war? I don't know. I think there's propaganda going on here, and I'm disgusted. After seeing that video, I'm so angry. That is a that whole video is about unity. And I love the way that yous all encompassed, even with the lipstick putting it on, it went all over the place. Even with the feminine guys doing their thing in their hand movements and their gestures, we're all one. And the computers on the heads, what's that about? It's symbolic of being programmed a certain way from way back, a certain way, a certain time that we almost have our heads stuck in the past. That's what it's symbolic to me. And that we can't erase what's been said, how we think, how we feel, but we need to. Like a computer, we need to erase the brain and say, look, today's the time, because of the freedom that we have in the world, of allowing people to live their lives the best way they can be. Whether it be sexual, I don't care. In my personal view, I feel live your life to make it happy. Do you know how many people said to me, at your age, you're setting up a music channel on YouTube? They're not laughing now. I'm known in many countries around the world. I have regular people following me, subscribing, liking me, loving my videos and reactions. But to this, it's about gender equality. She said she's beautiful, she's capable, she's her own queen, and she will prove it. When you are empowered by your own self-being, your own self-worth, as a woman. I'm going to say this from the women I know. I'm surrounded by very powerful women in the past, and I've leaned on them and learned from them. And even my younger sister has incredible way of thinking that it's empowering to listen to. I've grown up with four sisters that's empowered me. I've grown up with a powerful mother, an Irish woman. When we lived in England, had to protect her siblings because we were inundated with abuse because my mother came from Ireland, had a strong Irish accent. And whilst my father worked, she had to put up with the following women. But in the end, my mother won over them with unity and love, and they all almost bowed to her towards the end. And that made it better for us. Women are not to be dressed up. And like years ago when I was growing up, it was very traditional for girls to be dressed in dresses and boys to be out kicking a football and all of that. Those days are finished, everybody. Those days are finished. And girls had to dress like girls. But where I came from, when I was reared in England, part of my rearing was England, I experienced girls in the street acting tomboyish. They were very tough, very resilient. It was a working class area. And there was no having to dress up in a certain way. It was more in the middle class. At the time, there was middle class. I feel there's no middle class now. And there's no upper class because people's wealth has diminished and we're all becoming as one. But on a social scale, when I was young, the middle classes, upper classes, all dressed in pretty dresses in their nice little lawn gardens. They had grass, we had concrete, even if we had that. And we all played in the street, they played in the park, because they had a park. And we all ran around to each other's homes. They all had bikes and scooters and fancy little prams. And people were a certain way. It's about what I'm talking about, breaking down barriers, everybody. And I just feel this song is about breaking those barriers down and take your hands back. In other words, you were tied behind your back all your life when it came to sexuality, when it came to gender. You had to keep secret. You had to hide your face. You had to hide and just live a life in a very secretive way. But you know what's wonderful today? You can find a place in this world to be yourself. And people accept when they see you hold hands, when they see you kiss, when they see you express love. There's more tolerance than intolerance. I mean, I'm sure the song is about sisterhood as well, because you could move these lyrics to sisterhood in the Ukraine. But how? Because it's reflecting about gender inequality, everybody. It says, life's not like a money bag, blood's on guard's head. You can't steal our souls. You can't steal our souls. It's true. The church dictated to you. Parents were scared of the church dictated to you. Government set the rules about sexuality and how you live your lives in many countries, especially communist countries. Even today, we have situations in Iran where the women are protesting about having to cover up. They want to be more modern, and they're being condemned and jailed and tortured. People in China condemned, jailed and tortured if they think strongly as a woman. Take her out, torture her. It goes on, and it's about getting the hands round to the front and putting them together and praying to God that things can be easier. That's what this song's about. And it goes on, my sister's crown, don't take it down. In other words, what society, politics, the male old-fashioned way of living, go back to the computers on the head in the video. It's all about, we don't want to be programmed from the past. We want to have a new program, a new lease, a new way of thinking. And so it says, nobody can tie your hands in the back. We're not your dolls, it repeats. And then it continues, all the sisters of the world come together with a prayer, choose love over power. What a beautiful message in a song, everybody. Let's choose love in and above anything else. I lived a life of very conservative, head down, kept my nose clean, didn't wave a flag, didn't dress in crazy colors, didn't express myself. I have a lot of male testosterone in me more than female, but I'm a gay man. but I respect myself, and I respect that the fact, regardless of what gay communities think, we are a minority in a majority world of straight people. And we must accept that's always going to be, we're always going to be the smallest percentage. But we deserve to be recognized. We're human beings, because if you cut us, our blood is the same. So what I'm saying is, my sister's crown applies to men and women. It applies to everybody. Because that love, that passion, that desire in this song is universal, and it's felt, and I feel it. I personally don't think it's a song about politics. It's a song about love, and it's a song about sisters, wear your crown proudly, be yourself, move forth, be happy, stay positive. And Vesna, thank you for preaching such a wonderful, wonderful message on a global scale this coming May in Liverpool. We all need to hear it. That's what I think of this song. I love it. And that's why it's number 4 in my top 5. Fingers crossed. Take care.